Give all things to the power of the Holy Ghost. And we testify that your Heavenly Father, He loves each and every one of you.
Finish getting ready. I guess I just also like to add my testimony about baptism. I was baptized November 28th of 2020 during COVID. Just I know the changes that have been made in my life have been so great. Prior to that, I wasn't really religious myself. I didn't have any direction and stuff like that. Really getting baptized was the first step. It's been such a blessing to me. I've met so many people that I wouldn't have if I didn't accept that invitation to be baptized almost 3 years ago now. But it's just like a family, you know. There's so many times where I've had trials come in my life that, you know, without the gospel in my life, I wouldn't have been able to bear them so, I wouldn't say easily, but bear them. Because, you know, the atonement of Jesus Christ is there for all of us, and just being baptized and accepting that invitation to become baptized and follow Christ as an example, you know, something so great. And I know that Yasmin's decision to become baptized will bless her and also her family accordingly. I know it's done the same for me and my family, even though I'm the only member. I have seen that change in my family as well as myself, and it's something that I wouldn't have been able to, you know, do myself without the aid of my Heavenly Father and as well as my Savior and the Holy Ghost, which Yasmin will receive the gift of in a short time. But I just know that baptism is the first step. I know that if we choose to become baptized and to follow the example of our Savior Jesus Christ, we will be able to be made whole, even though we have trials in our lives, each of all of our lives. I know we come here to church or anything in life, we all have our trials that are, you know, feeling like they're weighing down heavily upon our shoulders. But when we choose to be baptized and we have the Holy Ghost, and we follow the Savior and His example, and we follow the commandments that our Heavenly Father has given us, I know that we'll be blessed accordingly, and that we will be able to endure to the end. These things I'll leave with you all in the name of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. again, congratulations, Yasmin. Really proud of you. I'm pretty sure everybody else is as well. It's a great thing to, you know, choose to be baptized. Now we'll have a special musical number performed by the Sister Missionaries and Mejia Tejaudi. As well, and then we'll have a talk on the Holy Ghost afterwards by Mejia Tejaudi as well. Thank you.
I didn't put them there, but we're going to use them. This.
Did you go look around and just see how many people are here to support you today? It's crazy. And it's really special to be able to know that you're making this commitment with your Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ. And I'm going to talk to you a little about the third member of Godhead, the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost, as you know in the Bible, shares with Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost is the opportunity for us to be able to know of the presence of our Heavenly Father in our lives. And it's a really beautiful thing when you're able to know. Sometimes when you notice it's missing, there's something different, and that's the Spirit. And you notice that is the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost comes, and now today, when after confirmation of the Holy Ghost, you'll have the opportunity to have the Holy Ghost with you all your life as a constant companion. As you're welcoming him in your life through what you decide to do in your life's work, study, and who you surround yourself with. And as you get to have that opportunity, then the Holy Ghost will be your constant companion forever. Now, we'll at times see that we're not always perfect. No, you're going to get that. This is more just little things to remind you about the Holy Ghost. So, the Holy Ghost is a survival kit for life. And this is knowing that he's our help to have a compass. So in the Book of Mormon, Lehi was a guiding light and ball, guiding the people, which is like a compass we have today. Guiding by our ability to keep the Spirit in our lives. If we're intention or we're angry with people or we have a disconnect, it's hard to have the Spirit. So trying to eliminate contention in our lives, as President Nelson has mentioned, and as the scriptures mentioned, we're able to have that constant companionship of the Holy Ghost. It's also like a whistle to remind us of what is going wrong. It's something we need to leave, we need to get out of the situation, and to know that the Spirit won't stay. But they'll tell you first, I can't be here. You want to go with me, but I'm not going to stay. And it's really important because we always have those challenges in our lives. And we need to know how to discern what is the Spirit and when we need to maybe adjust our compass to realize, okay, we need to be on the right track. Okay? And then it's always with us, connection. It could be a light to our lives. Be an opportunity, sometimes a light bulb, change something, or sometimes it's very emotional and something that really resonates in your heart of the truth of something being said or what someone's been able to share with you. And then to remember to record those things. If you're able to record them and remind yourself of the things that are important to you, then you'll always remember those moments, future in your life, when maybe you're doubting or you're having struggles that may be a challenge, right? You can remember that the Spirit's been there and I need to keep them. Okay. And then, this is giving you a jam, which is repentance. That's where we all make mistakes. We're not perfect. But Jesus Christ, through his atonement, made it possible for each of us to get through our challenges because we've got the opportunity to learn. We'll at times realize the Holy Spirit's not with us. We need to do something better. And if we need to adjust our lives, repentance is the way. And as President Nelson has said also, is daily repentance. Repent every day. We're able to say, oh, you know, I just want to be able to embrace the atonement of Jesus Christ in my life. Is there and loves you so much that he gave his life, gave everything for you. And Heavenly Father gave his only begotten Son. And the beauty of our lives here on earth is that we're able to have the constant companion of the Holy Ghost as we're working to keep him in our lives. And the testimony of Jesus Christ. Any questions? All right.
Thank you for that opinion. We'll now have our confirmation done by Brother Ellers.
Let's see, everybody that holds the Melchizedek priesthood can come on up here. We've got plenty of room. Yasmin Talia Adriana Cooper, by the authority of the Melchizedek priesthood, which we hold, we lay our hands upon your head and confirm you a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and say unto you, receive the Holy Ghost. Yasmin, Heavenly Father, is watching over you. He is pleased with the decision you have made to be a disciple of Christ, to be part of his church here upon the earth in these high places. We bless you to know that you will have an abundance of the Spirit in your life as you feel the influence of Heavenly Father, that you will be able to do the things that you are called upon to do by him. We bless you to be an example to others to always think about the other person and those that are less fortunate than you, that you will be able to help them in a way that nobody else would be able to help them because of the Spirit that you have and the love that you have for your fellow human beings here upon the earth. We bless you to know that. We bless you to know that Heavenly Father will watch over you. He will give you the help and strength you need to do the things that are in this life that are hard, especially those things that come upon you. You get down and you need an uplift, that you will have people around you and that you will have the Spirit to uplift you also. Believe that Heavenly Father watches over you, that he will continually be with you. We bless you to be happy. We bless you to be happy in your service to the Lord and when you serve others to be happy also. We bless you with health and with strength to be able to carry on in this world that we live in these latter days, that as things happen in this world and they affect your life, that you will be able to combat the evil that comes upon everybody, and that you will be able to rely upon Heavenly Father, and your life will be well. We bless you again to know that Heavenly Father loves you, he cares about you, he will watch over you. He has now blessed you with one of the greatest gifts anybody on this earth can have, and that's to be able to have the Spirit to be with you always, every second, every minute of your life. He loves you, Yasmin, and he will watch over you always. Rely upon your friends and the Spirit to be with you always as a guide and a protection. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. To us, and now you're also Sister Cooper. Don't feel old. Part of the family, and it's you have 17 million people around the world as part of your family, your church family. Anywhere you go in the world, you have friends. Sometimes it's hard to call on them because we want to be independent, but you have friends and family all over the world, and that's part of the family, the disciples of Jesus Christ. And so you'll be asked to serve. In the church, we have what they call lay ministry. Nobody's paid. You know, they don't pay to be the bishop. You don't pay to be the religious society president. They don't pay to be the elder president. And so you get the opportunity to serve. And through service, we are able to enjoy blessings in our lives. I may look like a grumpy old man, but I really do enjoy working with the YSA because they just are so vibrant and they're discovering life. You to be part of that. And we're excited to have you in the Lord, and we hope you feel welcome. And you know, bring your family and friends, and all, you know, they're all welcome. We want them to have that spirit of love and sisterhood, so to speak. So, anyway, welcome and take part. You'll get an opportunity to get a calling and serve, and hopefully they'll go to the temple and do all the different things that we have. We are just so excited to have you here as part of our Word family. And thank you for giving us the opportunity to serve you. We're just thrilled. So, welcome, and I want you to know that the gospel is true. That when they talk about the God the Father, Jesus Christ, appeared to a young boy in grove trees, I know that's true. As a family, we took a vacation and went and walked in that grove. And the Spirit abounds in that grove, and I encourage you to embrace the gospel and enjoy the blessings. And with that, you're on a sacred covenant path, and as you keep the commandments, you will find joy in your life. And that's what it's all about. Find that peace, calm, joy, and know that you're doing what the Lord wants you to do. And I leave that with you in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. We'll now sing our closing hymn, which is hymn number 193, I Stand All Amazed, and then we'll have a benediction given by Greg Lacy. When you give a benediction, can you make sure to bless the refreshments?
Dearly Father, we thank thee for this beautiful day and for this opportunity to all be here at this baptism. Thank you for thy spirit that is with us. And please bless every single one of us to be able to go and remember the things we've learned today.